Are you in customer service and want to create an AI agent? Well, let me show you how with Jotform. Hey, Jotformers, welcome back. I'm Kimberly. And like I mentioned, if you are in the customer service industry and you'd like to create an AI agent, you can absolutely do that with Jotform's AI agents. And it really is simple to do. Now, if you already have a form that you are utilizing to collect data from your users, you can easily turn any form into an AI agent. So for example, I'm gonna go ahead and look at this weekly budget form. If I click on more, over on the left-hand side under publish, we have create an agent. But for this example, I'm actually going to utilize a template. So in the top left-hand corner, we can come up here to create and we'll choose AI agent. And from here, you get to choose the channel that you would like your agent to be. Now, don't get too hung up on which channel to choose, because once you get started, you have access to every single channel. So for this example, I'm going to utilize the standalone, which is the very first one that's already chosen. So let's go ahead and choose next. And here we have four different options in order to start creating. The first is going to be start from scratch, which is starting from scratch. So if you know exactly what you want it to look like, that's going to be the option for you. We can start with a form from here, same way as we did in the My Workspace area. We have utilized a template, or we can clone ourselves and our knowledge. So I'm going to use the use template option. And if you're familiar with our normal form builder template gallery or any of our template galleries, this is just the same. You can scroll through our most popular ones. On the left-hand side, we do have by industry, by types, and by language. But if you know what you're looking for, you can always utilize the search up at the top. But since we are utilizing customer support, I'm just gonna use that very first one, the customer support AI agent. If you want, you can click the preview option to preview what it looks like before choosing it. But I'm just gonna go ahead and use agent. All right, so anytime you create a brand new agent, you're automatically going to land in the build tab. This is going to allow you to change the way that everything looks about your agent. Now, like I mentioned, over on the left-hand side, you have access to every single one of those channels. We have the standalone, chatbot, voice, phone, SMS, WhatsApp, Messenger. So after you're done building and designing your AI agent, make sure you come over and click through each one of these just to make sure that it looks fine on each platform. So back up to standalone. If I go to the right-hand side, I'm gonna go to our designer, and here is where we can change the way our agent avatar looks. This is going to be this person right here. So if we want, we can choose the gallery, and this is gonna give us an extensive image gallery to pull from. We can do a quick scroll. We can see that we landed on the generate tab, so we can type in what we want our avatar to look like. We can even see right here, it says wearing a mic. So you can be very, very specific. We can see that she is wearing a mic right here. Or if you have a mascot, or maybe someone who is a dedicated customer support agent for you, you can upload their picture or their likeness to be your avatar. Then if we go to style, we can change the overall color theme of this. If we want to change the colors, we can do that. I'm going to go with this very first one. So we can see the start and end color. We have the agent color, this text right here. We also have the page background. We can see that it's automatically going to come with this geometric shape background. But if you want, you can easily remove that and upload a new one. Or if you want, we can add in some colors. We can keep it like that, kind of like the ombre effect. But let's X out of this. If I click on this piece right up here, we can change what that looks like. We can change that welcome message. We can even turn it off. We can change what that looks like right here, but I'm gonna go ahead and leave it on because I do like it. We can turn off these buttons right here, and we can also change what these buttons say. Now, most likely, both of these buttons are going to be attached to a form, which I'll show you in just a second, and we can even add in a new button. We also have our menu option, which is going to pop up when people click right here on this menu option. All right, let's jump up to the train tab because this is where a bulk of information is going to take place. So I'm gonna head over to the train tab. We start in the knowledge base piece, but I'm gonna jump up one into that AI persona. Here we can change the agent's name if you want to give them a specific name and not a title. You can absolutely do that. We can change their role. Maybe they are a customer care agent. We get to change that default language. Next, we have the tone of voice. We have casual, professional, or friendly. We also have chat's response length. We have minimal all the way up to chatty. Somewhere between short and long is going to be a good place to land. We can see these chat guidelines. These are all going to be created by AI, so make sure you take a peek here. And if you want to add a new one, we can see this says you provide clear and concise answers. We can add in new chat guidelines here. All right, let's jump down to that knowledge base. So even though this is a template, it's automatically loaded with some knowledge. So let's look at the different ways that you can add in extra knowledge to your AI agent. If we click on add new knowledge, the first one is going to be add text-based information to train your agent. So here you can copy and paste from documents or your website or anything that you need to copy and paste from, you can put it in here. Next, we have links. You can paste in your website link and you can choose pages within your website for it to crawl. So it's not gonna just crawl the one page that you give it, you can actually have it crawl multiple pages within your website, which is really helpful. We have a file, so if you have a PDF or a doc, you can upload that here. So that way the agent will look at that document and analyze it to use, and you can just say this right down here, describe how your agent should use this file. You can say something like analyze this file and use it to answer questions. Then if we head back, we have question and answer. So if you have very specific FAQs that you know you're going to get, this is a great place to do that. You can add in that question and add in the answer. Now, if at any point someone is utilizing your AI agent and your AI agent doesn't know the answer, it's going to land right back over here as a Q&A. And it's going to look similar to this, but it's gonna have a red X letting you know, hey, your AI agent didn't know how to answer this question. Answer it here so we know next time. But we can see here, we have some knowledge base. We have some support services overview. We have those general FAQs. How can I submit a support request? What information? You can see there's just some general information that you can add in or that has already been added for you. Now on the left-hand side, we have some actions. You can think of these as conditional logic if you're familiar with our form builder. So for here at the top, you have to choose the channel that you want to apply this to. I'm gonna go ahead and leave it on all channels. So here you can see when. So when something happens, what do you want your AI agent to do? So for example, if the user asks about something specific, you can ask them to fill out a form, you can show a button, you can give them a video to watch, you can make an appointment. Lots of different things that you can do in order to have your AI agent really take on the responsibility for you. Next on the list, we have tools. This is going to be kind of like our integration. So if you want your users to upload something, maybe a PDF, or maybe you want them to schedule an appointment, you can do that here. You have to set the appointment with Google Calendar. We also have Google Drive and Box. Lots of different things that we can do. But if you don't see a tool that you would like to see, make sure you utilize this requested tool option right here. Next, we have forms. So you can see that because we created a template, it automatically created three brand new forms for us. So if you are utilizing the free version of Jotform, which allows you to have 5 forms, keep that in mind. If you create an AI agent from a template, it might end up putting you over your form limit. And last, we have teach your agent. So this allows you to have a conversation with your agent in order to teach them. So if we went up here to preview to test this and your agent didn't know the answer to a question, you wouldn't be able to say, hey, remember this for next time. Here, you can do that. So if they don't know the answer to a question, you say, hey, add this to your knowledge base so the next time someone asks this question, you'll know the answer. All right, jumping over to our publish. We have it as a public agent, which means anyone can utilize it by copying the link. We can invite by email. We can share through the standard social media or QR code channels. We have our embed options as well. So we can do it as a page embed. We have the chatbot, WordPress, Lightbox, or pop-up. You'll choose whichever one you would like and you can copy that code. Then on the left-hand side, we're gonna go into each one of the different type of agents in order to edit or look at that published style. So here we have our chatbot and we can see this is what that chatbot is going to look like. We have, hi, how can I assist you? We can edit that here. We can turn off that pulsating effect if you would like, but you have have the code for each one of these as you go through. Now, if you're going to choose the phone agent or the SMS agent, you're going to need to purchase a phone number at this time, so keep that in mind. But with a voice agent, that is going to come stock on your AI agent. So if you have someone who's utilizing it, they can always switch over to voice agent to have that conversation. And we can also change our voice agent's voice, how they sound. We get to choose a language, accent, gender, and age. So we get to choose what that looks like, and we can even take a listen.
Jotform AI agents are powerful tools that...
So you can see what they look like, and you can choose one that's going to fit you best. I personally like
Jotform
Matilda.
Jotform AI agents are powerful tools that handle tap.
I like Matilda, so I'm gonna use Matilda. But you can see you have the same information, the sharing the agent and the embed. We can jump down. We have WhatsApp, we have Gmail, Zoom, and a Messenger agent. We also have the ability to embed on different platforms. And again, if you don't see your platform shown, always request it. And then we can turn our AI agent into an app. So if you're familiar with our Jotform apps, it's very similar to that, but it is just going to be the AI agent. And you have the same information. You can change the app name and icon, the splash screen, and you can even send push notifications. So let's go ahead and do a quick preview before we wrap up. All right, we see it. We have our AI agent here to help. How can I assist you today? So if we want, we can click on this menu and we can see the different options. We also have those connected forms that we can utilize. But let's do request support now. Now we can see that it's asking for our order reference number. This is starting to pull from a form. Now keep in mind, if you're utilizing a form, make sure if you need a piece of information, you mark it required. We can see right here that this skip is available. So this means that this question on the form is not required. So we can go ahead and skip. Then down here at the bottom, you can see the percent complete of the form. If your user would like, they can actually click on open form and they can completely bypass this conversation piece. Let's go ahead and open the form and see what the rest looks like. We have email, phone number, having problems. We can upload files. We have that urgency level and how I'd like to be contacted. Perfect. And it really is as simple as that. If you have any questions about how to build your own AI agent for your customer support team, let us know down below in the comments. If you like this video and you got some value, hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you get a notification every time we put out a new video. I'll see you next time.